A kind of recreation that people can tell and people can see in your life. The preparation you will make, the response you will give to the Lord, so that what He wants to do, tonight is your night. Where are you? I said tonight is your night. That pain, He'll strike it off. That infirmity, He will strike it off. Those blind eyes will become bright in tonight. I will see. I said I will see. And out of that wheelchair, the mighty power of God will come upon your life. You'll come out in Jesus' name. But there must be a preparation from your side. Our preparation for His noticeable healing. Number three, your portion in His new holiness. You have a portion in what God has provided through Christ. I was quoting for year by amen. That's your portion. You will not miss it in Jesus' name. Let's come back to number one. The perception of His notable honor. Come back to Genesis chapter 1. And I'm reading here from verse 26. Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness. And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. So God created man. And then He tells us, in His own image, in the image of God created He him. Male and female created He them. And God blessed them. Somebody is blessed today, and God bless them. Somebody there, you are blessed tonight, and God bless them. Every curse will vanish away from your life. Every plant the Heavenly Father has not planted tonight will be uprooted from your life in Jesus' name. The perception of His notable honor. How do you understand? I'm telling you something here. If you know what God thinks about you, if you know what God desires for you, you will not fall for anything lower. You will not accept and say, okay, if this is all I have, then that's all right. You'll say no. Before this life ends, everything God ordained for you, everything God has earmarked for you, and He says, in this new creation, this is what I have for you, you're going to possess it. Nothing will stop you. If you don't stop yourself, if you have the right perception, and you make the proper preparation, and you recognize your portion, I'm telling you, from tonight, your life will be totally different. In the creation that God has made, what do you see? Number one, honor
through God.
Oni ola nipase Olorun.
Honor through God.
Ola lati odo Olorun.
His honor will not come to your life anymore.
Aiwa lola ko ni wa soju
ona. His grace will not come to your life anymore.
Awon abuku tabi egan ko ni wa sona re.
Depression will not come to your life anymore.
Idiba je ko wa ni wa sunu aye re.
Number 1, honor.
Ikini oni ola.
I'm looking at Psalm 8.
Won worry Dafidi ori kejo.
Psalm 8 verse 3.
Ori Dafidi ori kejo
ese keta. When I consider the heavens.
Nigbati mo ru orun re.
The work of thy fingers.
Ise ika re.
The moon and the stars.
Osupa ati irawo.
Which thou hast ordained.
Ti iwa ti se ilana sile.
What is man that thou art mindful of him?
Kile eniyan ti iwa fi se iranti
re. Or the son of man that thou visitest him.
Ati ombe eniyan ti iwa fi nbe wo.
Thou hast made him a little lower than the angels.
Iwo sa da rele die ju angeli lo.
Only a little lower than the angels.
O da rele die ju angeli lo.
And has crowned him with glory and honor.
Iwo si ti fi ogun ati ola de ile ade.
Remember, this is not Genesis, this is Psalm.
Unati o Genesis ko lele yori Dafidi lele yo.
Thousands of years after creation. And David was saying, I look at man at my own time.
David was in
the marriage of God. In the plan of God. Glory and honor. Tonight you are coming to that honor. You are coming to the creation of God. You are coming to his desire and his purpose and plan for you.
Verse 6,
thou hast made him to have dominion over the works of thy hand.
He was in Mujoba, is your war.
Thou hast put all things under his feet.
He was it if you go Sabe Sere.
Under his feet.
Sabe Sere.
I'm going to make it personal.
Under
my feet.
What if one Sabe Atelesemi?
Under my feet.
Labi Atelesemi.
Evil powers under my feet.
Ogwagbara okunkun. Labi Atelesemi.
Under my feet.
Aisan. Abi Atelesemi.
Cancer under my feet.
Ogwo Jaranjegun. Labi Esemi.
Ulcer under my feet.
Ogwo Benu. Labi Esemi.
Premature death under my feet.
Ikwa Itojo. Labi Atelesemi.
Calamity under my feet.
Ajalu. Labi Atelesemi.
He has given us honor. That's why Christ came. Christ didn't come so I can just go to church. I can go to church without Christ coming.
The
people were going to their synagogues without Christ coming. They were going to their temples without Christ coming. Christ came. So he can take you out of that place of dishonor.
Christy, what Kyoba le mua
bring you to the platform of honor.
Kyowa mua sorry pepe.
And bring all the things that were crawling upon you before, all the things destroying your life before, he'll put them under your feet from today.
Did you
hear what he said? Behold, I give unto you power over all the power of the enemy. Said, you will tread on serpents and scorpions. And then he says, nothing shall by any means hurt you. He has come back from heaven so that the original creation will be reproduced in your life tonight.
Honor through
God.
Ola lati odo Olorun.
Obedience to God.
Igboran si Olorun.
You know, as Christ came,
o ma bi Christ today,
and then he comes into our heart,
o wa sinu okan wa,
he puts a magnet in our heart.
O wa fi onfa kan si inu okan wa.
You are magnetic ties to the side of the Lord. There is a desire to obey God. There is a pleasure in obeying God. When God created Adam and Eve, that was what was in their heart. They just love God. And they love the commandments of the Lord. Number one, honor to God. Number two, obedience to God. Number three, likeness to God. Let us create man in our image, in our
likeness. That he is the creature resembled the creator. The son resembled the father. The offspring resembles the parents. Likeness unto God. And that's why it says that as he is, so are we in this present world. The next one is the image of God.
The
created man. After our likeness, after our image, so that the very heart of God, the very mind of God, the very nature of God, that's what Adam and Eve are. That's what they lost. And that's why Jesus Christ has come. He wants to restore us back to what we lost in Adam. Honor through God. Obedience to God. Likeness to God. The image of God. Nature of God. The nature of God. Is the nature of dominion. The nature of power. The nature of righteousness. The nature of truth. The nature of truthfulness. The nature of holiness. Because that's how God created man. The perception we have. Some people do not understand why Jesus came. He looked at every couch. He looked at every step. And he looked at every item. That man should resemble God. And we lost everything. And Jesus Christ has now come. So that he will restore you to that nature of God. He exploits like God. Exploits like God. Look at Adam. Can you think of one man and one woman? Controlling that whole garden. Controlling all the earth. And he told Adam and Eve. Subdue the earth.
Only Emma Jacob Alori
won't just the garden.
Only say Kawan Kissy or
man could go anywhere.
Or Kuriel Lossy
before he fell.
Kotosubu.
His word was with authority.
Orore only a senior.
Before he fell,
Kotosubu.
Lions were not a threat to him.
Before
he fell, crocodiles were not a threat to him.
Kotosubu or Niwarakabo.
Before he fell, he had exploits like God.
That's
what the Lord is bringing us to. The people that do know their God. And the people that do know Christ. And Christ pulls you out of your disgrace and degradation. He pulls you out. Power will come into you.
You'll
not be afraid of little malaria.
Oh, niwa ma berui ba kekeke.
You'll not be afraid of cockroach spirit.
Oh, niwa ma berue emi anyo.
You will not be afraid of reptiles.
Oh, niwa ma beru gbogbo awon omo le tabi awon
langa. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof.
Tori pe ti Oluwa ni ile ati ekun inu
re. This is my father's territory.
Ese ewo baba mi.
And anywhere you are,
Ibi-kibi-to-ba-si-wa.
Authority and dominion.
Ase ati ijegaba.
You go to the village.
O lo si abule.
Authority and dominion.
Ase ati ijegaba.
Anywhere you go.
Ibi-kibi-to-ba-lo.
You're not hiding yourself somewhere.
O ma farapamasi-bi-kan.
There are some bad people there. They want to kill me.
Awe yaburuko kanwa miwale pa mi o.
No.
Rara o.
Nobody will kill you. After tonight. I said after tonight. In the day and in the night. You will do exploits in Jesus' name. And then supernatural through God. The supernatural through God. In the original creation. Man was representative of heaven on earth. It was the sub-headquarters of God here on earth. And man was to be the administrator of God here on earth. The plan of heaven was to be carried out on earth by the man. And the power of heaven was given to him to carry that out. Supernatural from God. The supremacy in God. The supremacy that he had in God. That's what Adam and Eve had at the beginning. And then there was a fall. And man now became helpless, hopeless, sick, suffering, sorrowful, until Christ came. And Christ is asking you tonight, do you want to come back to where you were before? Yaba is not answering me.
Ara Yaba o dawo.
I said, do you want to come back to what we had before?
Njo fe pada sipo ta ti wa tele ri bere pepe.
We're coming back.
A n pada sibe.
I said we're coming back.
Oni a o pada sibe.
Courage is coming to your heart.
Igboya o nwo enu okan
re lo. Life is coming to you.
Iye o nwo enu re lo.
Authority is coming to you.
Ase o nwo enu re lo.
You will not continue in weakness.
Oni tesiwaju ninu
ore yen. You will not continue in discouragement.
Oni tesiwaju ninu idaya foye.
You will not continue in fear. You will not continue in poverty. Christ has come. Christ died for you on the cross of Calvary. Looking unto Christ, the author and finisher of your faith, who for the joy that was set before him, he despised the shame, he endured the cross, so that he'll take you out of that place you are, he'll take you up. You're coming up tonight. Our preparation for his noticeable health. He's going to heal you. Somebody there said he's going to heal you. Get ready, it's coming. Miracle of healing. Miracle of salvation. Miracle of deliverance. It's coming your way in Jesus' name. Our preparation. What preparation do you make? And if you will prepare tonight, I can assure you a miracle is coming your way. What preparation do you make? Humble yourself before the Lord. Humble yourself before the Lord.
He
said in 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14. If my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sin. I will heal their land. Humble yourselves before the Lord. Oh, open the door of your heart to the Lord. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door and he says, Jesus, I want you. Jesus, I desire you. Jesus, I believe you died for me on the cross of Calvary.